good afternoon. I hope you had a really enjoyable lunch. I really had. May I start by saying how glad I am to see you all here in Stockholm today, and like to add how proud we are to be able to host this Stockholm Internet Forum as a global multi-stakeholder event which highlights the vital importance of the internet, an internet for us all, I would say. I'm sure that we will have really positive, fruitful discussions during these 2 days about the challenges we are facing, but also about the opportunities that we can take and really build on together. Over the past year, I must say that I've been really, really impressed when I see the real engagement that I've been seeing from individuals, from countries, from companies, from organizations all over the world. And we really see impressive results. In the Middle East, brave men and brave women really defy dictatorships with the use of modern technology, among other things. In countries such as Kenya, millions of people have been given access to modern banking services thanks to mobile banking. And all over the world, motivated students now have access to the most prestigious academic programs thanks to the open courses of Yale and Harvard. These few examples, along with many other equally impressive developments, once again show us just how central the internet really is for development and for communication in society and between societies. The internet really gives us the ability to bridge the gaps and overcome the divides between people, between cultures, and between countries throughout the world. The internet not only gives us real opportunities for the freedom of information, but also for the freedom of expression and for fully taking part in the political processes and in democracy. And therefore, we must say that internet is really a vital platform for democracy itself. So that's why the internet cannot be governed by one actor or a few sectors or stakeholders, because the internet truly, truly belongs to us all. That's why Sweden strongly supports the idea of the multi-stakeholder model. We want to strengthen true multi-stakeholder participation, true multi-stakeholder engagement in internet governance, and whenever and wherever we discuss internet-related matters. But you know, it's not just a question of transparency, or not just a question of engagement. It's also a question of understanding. We have different roles, different responsibilities, and different skills that must all be respected on an equal footing to achieve a proper dialogue for the right results. And this is regardless of what stakeholder group we belong to. This is regardless of what country we come from, and regardless of our religion or our culture. And it's also regardless of what gender we have, and regardless of our age. The dialogue within the multi-stakeholder model must continue, and also must integrate the business sector, because a truly open internet is one of the most important driving forces for innovation, for new services, and for efficient competition. At a time when more and more services in society are really going digital, everyone must be able to make use of the opportunities that are created. Everybody must be able to use the internet, use other digital services in their everyday life, regardless if they are a business owner, an employee, or only a citizen. And again, regardless of age, of language, of gender, or disabilities. This is the truly inclusive digital society that I would like to see. And that idea of an open digital society for all was really my priority in taking the initiative in creating the digital agenda for Sweden. An agenda that the Swedish government presented last year and which sets out a really, really clear goal, which is that Sweden shall become the global leader in using the opportunities of digitization. To work and lead across the board, be it IT in schools, in health, or in dealing with a digital divide. The most important tool, I think, to ensure access to internet services of choice is properly functioning competition in the market. This includes foremost consumers having access to clear and adequate information about the terms and conditions of their internet subscription. I think it's obvious that the market for electronic communication is in a truly critical phase. New business models are developing whilst major investments in next generation networks are really needed. And that's why I and the Swedish government, together with PTS, our Swedish regulator and host here today, and along with other stakeholders, will monitor the situation very, very closely to ensure that we put the focus firmly on the consumer and really create a fully functioning market in this respect. I think transparency is really, really key in fostering a proper debate on all the challenges facing the ICT sector. And in addition, responsible business practice by the ICT industry itself that has a major role to play in enhancing internet freedom and human rights. For as we mention in the Swedish digital agenda, IT policy fundamentally relates to other goals and policies. Today, we all face many very, very great challenges. Climate change, aging populations, and in too many parts of the world, still an ongoing assault on the free speech. A potential threat against the open nature of the internet would be to make internet service providers who are only transmitting the services responsible for the content that is sent in their communication networks. Such a liability would seriously risk the openness of the internet and must be avoided. But my friends, great challenges also provide great opportunities. And to realize them, we really must work hard and we must work hard together. Here too, we need a continuous dialogue between different sectors, a dialogue based on openness, transparency, and true understanding. The fact that I and others are here today shows that IT policy is such an important tool for development policy and for foreign policy makers. Today we are taking one step further in our dialogue for an inclusive digital society on a global scale. The internet is going to be more and more important for us all, and we need to understand that we are all really part of the internet, no matter who we are or where we are. We need to understand that when we connect a home network to an access provider, then we really actually run and are responsible for a small part of the internet. The internet is really important to all of us, but we are also all of us important for the internet too. If we can make sure that the internet is a truly open channel for everyone, for information, for opinions, and for business, we will also make sure that our world and our humanity will develop both successfully and democratically around the world. So, as well as a pleasant stay here in Stockholm, I would also like to wish you all the best of meetings and success in this vital dialogue here today, tomorrow, and in the future. Thank you.